every other antiphonal. There we go. We almost had to do it memorized. Okay, so you guys see the bolder print, and you're the italics. Okay, so here we go. Praise the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His mighty deeds. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. Praise Him with trumpet sound. Praise Him with lute and harp. Praise Him with tambourine and dance. Praise Him with strings and pipes. Praise Him with sounding cymbals. Praise Him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord together.
Praise the Lord.
Lord, everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. We are so grateful. And so today, Lord, as we come together, we call it a Lord's Day. It's a day of recognizing resurrection, a day of recognizing the body of Christ coming together. And Father, in the body of Christ, local and abroad, Lord, you have people that are gifted, the servants, and we're grateful, the chosen's here. Lord, just bless and guide. May our hearts be blessed and ministered, and as may we be a blessing to them as well. We thank you, Father, for this day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Chosen.
How's everybody doing so far today? Would it be all right if you guys sing one with us? Our voices are still warming up. Like you said, we played in the rain, which was a blast. We don't do that very often. The guitar was so slippery, you keep sliding past all your notes, and then it quit raining and got muggy. So now you can't get to any of your notes. So we went from being sharp to flat. And then yesterday we were in the sun, well, some of us were, as you can tell by the drummer's face there. We were under a tent, and we sang for 2.5 hours. So to a bunch of bikers, which was pretty cool. But it'd be all right, can you guys sing a song with us? It goes like this. It goes, sing, I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
How about you? And we all sing, I love Jesus. Yes, I do. I love Jesus. How about you? Sing, I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
Sing, I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Well, how about you?
How about you?
Sing, I love Jesus. Yes, I do.
How about you?
Sing, I love Jesus.
Yes, I do.
How about you?
Sing, I love Jesus.
Yes, I do.
doesn't want me to do this next part anymore. And so we didn't do it Friday night. And I heard, no joke, from three or four different people who came to the table and said, every time you do that song, you better have Josh do what we're getting ready to do. So.
I think we should vote not to do it, actually. Can I give it some hands?
No, you want to hear it. So my question is there any Elvis fans in the building? Here's the truth. Josh is a huge Elvis fan.
Yes,
so much so, Josh went to Nashville to learn how to sing like Elvis. Yeah, you guys know where we're going with this, huh? Would anybody like to hear Elvis a little bit this morning? Yeah, right? All right, Josh, we'll see you. Here we go. Sing one you know here. Sing, oh Lord, my God. You.
joy shall fill my heart.
That's my favorite part.
Then I will bow in humble adoration and live proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Oh, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. Oh, how great thou art. Yeah.
don't know about you, but I'm thankful for the blood this morning. We're the band chosen. We feel like we've been chosen by God to be used for God. Let me tell you who's up here real quick. Over there on the bass guitar is my youngest brother of the five. Oldest, 7 years later, here he is. I would say I'm the better looking one. But my goal is to keep him 7 years ahead of me. I don't know if it's always working, but we're close. We're probably 3.5-ish. We're getting it. But if you're enjoying Mitch on the bass, one of the finest bass players I've ever played, we'll give it up for Mitch. Back here on the drums, so we had my other brother play drums originally when we started in 2007. Fantastic drummer. Left us in, what was it, 2012. Jake came on as a 14-year-old. Check out the weekend we sent Jake out. The first time he's ever played drums. He played drums in public one time before then. The very first weekend we played, we started at his high school. That was his first show with us. The second show, we played Blessing of the Bikers with about 1,000 bikers dressed in leather. Can I say this? All of our songs were fast songs that day. The slow songs were fast songs that day. Since then, he's more than one of the best drummers, again, I've ever played with. Been with us since 2012. Get up for Mr. Jake Keim on the drums. So when we started this, or when I started this, we grew up singing Southern gospel music with my family, the Thurston family. You know, we were Alliance before that, we were Majestics before that. They've been doing it since before we were born. They had pictures of being three on the steering wheel of a bus, you know, and I was the same size as it. We've been on the road since then. Rich started running sound at 9, was the lead singer at 14, like who does that, right? That was what we grew up playing and singing. So when we came off the road with them, I started a youth ministry called Chosen. And all we did is play youth shows. We were crazy. We had a lot of hair, three different colored hair. We'd do guitar flips. A couple of times the guitar hit the wall. I stopped doing guitar flips because I lost a couple of guitars. We were just those guys. And we needed a bass player. And so I called a buddy of mine who's actually our piano player in the picture, the one that's not here. And that's how I met him, was playing bass. Well, when he came up the road with us, I needed a bass player. Me and Mr. Josh Shakuro here went to church together, and he goes, I played the bass. I was like, I didn't know that, because you always played the guitar. So he came on the road as our bass player. And then we picked up Mitch from the Thurstons when he could get released from dad every now and then. And then Josh goes, well, I play guitar. I'm like, yeah, I know that, because we go to church together and play guitar on the opposite sides of the stage. Since then, he's become our full-time guitar player since 2010. Give it up for Mr. Josh Zakur. You call him Dad. And if you want a deal on any of the product later, talk to Dad, because he never sells at full price. He's the guy. He is the guy. Yesterday, we sold all the CDs for $5 cheaper than, and I like to. So I'm like, thanks, Dad. Gave him all the deal. You know, hey, here's the coolest part. We simply were chosen by God for God. We said, God, send us where you want us to go. And we started in all youth venues. And then we started meeting with these bikers in a unique kind of way. The first year we were playing the biker show, we went to get a picture with one guy who was about 6'11", in nothing but biker gear. And Josh touched his shoulder, he goes, hey, to get a picture with him. Because he was, you know, Jake's not 6'11", let's just say it that way. We thought it'd be a funny picture. And the guy about ripped our heads off. Believe, touch me. And that was the kind of ministry that we started getting into. I'm like, man, this is crazy. And we started playing as rocky of Christian music as we could get to minister to these guys. And out of 1,000 bikers, we saw maybe 40 come to receive the Lord the first year that we played. Amen. And then we just kept going and kept going. And one pastor goes, why don't you guys do worship music? I'm like, that's a great idea, because we're all on worship teams at our church. We just never thought about that. And so then we started coming and leading people in worship and having nights of worship and watching people's lives be changed through that ministry. And then we have a weekend like this where we are in the rain playing everything from, I think we had Lutheran, Reformed, Assembly of God, Church of God, Pentecost. So I'm sure there's a couple other types of people at the show Friday night that we play music for. And then we go Saturday to play for a group of bikers who are, just saying,
They're different. When you're playing and you start just, you know, just getting different vibes and you start getting a little, I said it last time this way, just you get the munchies because, you know, you're smelling certain smells that are coming around. It's a unique group to just, yeah, so it's catching on. And you sing in Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone with bikers who are smoking in front of you. And they don't think about it. And then we played an event called Rock the Violence out of Flint. We were the only Christian band there. Cool opportunity, right? Until you bring your kids and the rap group in front of you is not singing lyrics I want my kid to hear. So we put the kids back in the car while we set up. And you just have people dancing and worshiping the Lord and ministering the gospel. And so we just go wherever God tells us to go. And then we're with you guys this morning. So think about our weekend. We go from rain to bikers that are all crazy. And, you know, this was how they worshiped the whole time, you know. And now we're with you guys. It's just awesome to be used by God. And we say, God, open the door. And all we want to do is share your love with them. Share your love through song. So this next song that we're going to play is the first song.
Okay, Eric didn't introduce himself, so I want to listen to that. No, he doesn't, but I would like to. This is the definite leader of this group, and he has such a big heart for God and for people. And so this is Eric Thurston, and without him, I don't think we could do this. So give it up for Eric Thurston.
So the first song we ever learned, so again, the bass player story, right? Mike, the piano player, played bass, then Josh played bass, and now Mitchell plays bass, and then I actually play bass. So when I got pushed off the bass, because my dad's like, I'm not learning a new instrument, you're younger than me, you learn how to play guitar, I was 15 years old. And so we were at a Southern Gospel event, National Chord Tech Convention. A guy came on the bus and taught me my first song I ever learned how to play guitar, because it's easy, was, there ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. And then it took us forever to switch, because it was hard back then. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. That's when we started playing guitar. We found a new version that works almost every church we go to. It'll be all right if we play it for you?
Yeah. All right,
we're going to do that anyways.
Oh, shame is a prison, as cruel as a grave. Shame is a robber, and he's come to take my name. Oh, love is my redeemer, lift me up from the ground. Love is the power where my freedom song is found. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. You guys believe that this morning? Yeah. There ain't no grave trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise up out of the ground. There ain't no grave Now there was a battle, a war between death and life. And there on the tree, the Lamb of God was crucified. Well, he went on down the hill and took back his
says, I'm so thankful God sent his son Jesus Christ to die for me. Are you thankful for that? It changes everything. It changes our life. But remember, as a Christian, you're not the only one. God sent his son Jesus to die for you, but we're not the only one. We're called to make disciples. We're called to share God's love to others. So this song simply says, I'm not the only one. You gave your son for me, and he died at Calvary. He came to set me free, to live eternal. So I could So what we actually did is we picked the top five praise and worship songs that we were hanging out with at that time, and we put that on the CD to complete it. So we'll come back later and do a little bit of the worship stuff and just worship with you guys. Praise and worship, I think, is such a huge part of getting through this. Can you imagine trying to get through COVID and everything without God? Not having a clue, but not having anybody to turn to? It would be crazy. But while we were writing this, we were writing a song. We had a Mitchell's writing a song that he had the theory of God is good all the time God is good. And we were trying to find a way to write a song along those lines, and it just seemed like one attack after another. With life, with the year we went through, with work, we were on a fertilization and weed control company. Tried doing that when nobody can work for 2 or 3 months in the hottest part of springtime when everybody has weeds and fertilizer needs. And we can only sell stuff basically through Memorial Day. So it was one test after another, one test after another. And Mitch pulled into the shop as it was raining. And then all of a sudden the sun comes out on top of the storm. And the song, and then it was a rainbow too, or yeah, sun, rainbow came out on top of the storm. And we always get nervous when we play this song, because the other day when it was raining, we told the story about how it was raining, and then, you know, the sun came out and everything. The rain picked up when we started playing. The sun came out, and then everybody grabs their cameras and start taking pictures, but they're not taking pictures of us. I mean, we're kind of cool, but we're not that cool. And we're here, and they're pointing over here. What's going on? And we turn around, there's a double rainbow. But this song simply says, even in the middle of the storm, God is good. Listen to the song Mitchell wrote.
You ever have a time when life hits in the moment? You think that this is it.
No matter how strong the winds
sharing today. Great talent. We're glad that you're here, and I'll be back.
Switch songs on them. They're gonna catch up here. We're gonna follow the lyrics still on the screen if you guys want to sing with us.
Your faithfulness, oh God.
You know, the song always reminds me, my chains are gone, I've been set free. And the thing that I always think about during this song, just how my brain works, if I was chained, I really wouldn't be able to move. I really wouldn't be able to do anything, because obviously you're not very free. And you know, if you're living in the free place today, I encourage you to just be happy about that. Just celebrate that. So when we sing this last chorus, I always encourage somebody, just do a little something you couldn't do if you were stuck. Maybe you move a little. Maybe it's just raising your hands a little, just because you can, celebrating the freedom, celebrating what God's done for you. And you know what? If you're going through something today, and maybe you're not feeling very free, I encourage you just to do something you couldn't do if you weren't chained by faith. Because God's the same yesterday, today, and forever. If he's done it once, he'll do it again. He's an unchanging God. So if he's ever showed up in your life before, he will show up again. The Bible says we just have to stand on his promises. So when we get this last chorus, if you're living in a free place, if you need a little bit of faith to get through something, I encourage you, just do something you couldn't do if you were stuck. Would that be all right? Say, the earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbid to shine. But God, who called me below, will be forever.
Oh God, you are forever.
So grateful. Thank you, gentlemen, for sharing. I'm going to share a few moments in the Word, and they're going to kind of a postlude play a song or two. And I told them, as long as you're still there and engaging, you'd enjoy it. So do what you need to do. And I tell you what, there'll be no Sunday school after this. This will be our time of friendship and sharing together. So can you imagine with me, just close your eyes for a moment. Don't sleep. Just close your eyes for a moment. And you're out in the open field, and you're by yourself. Can you see that? In an open field, but your eyes are closed now. And you open your eyes, and you see 10 million warriors. Imagine that with me. Just try to grasp 10 million. 9 million, 11 million, just millions of warriors, angelic beings. Now open your eyes and read. This is from the Net Bible, and I read this the other day, and I like how it's written. Together, let's read. This also comes from the Lord, who commands armies, who gives supernatural guidance, and imparts great wisdom. This year I'm reading through with the Net Bible. I like the choice of words. But we've been studying in Sunday school angelic beings, holy and unholy. And the scriptures talk about myriads of angels. There could be millions of angels. So in your mind and by faith, when God speaks, he is not only a resurrected Lord, but he commands possibly millions and millions and millions of angelic beings. And someday he's coming back, right? In power. And in the meantime, this same God imparts to us, gives us, and I like this choice of word, supernatural guidance. And imparts great wisdom. Has anybody ever needed guidance? Anybody need any wisdom? The one who can truly give it has granted it. If we ask for wisdom and faith, James calls us. And I like that aspect, the supernatural. It's more than this word guidance is also used in Hebrew for counsel. And we know the Holy Spirit, the paraclete, the one that comes alongside that guides. He's the one. So he commands. He is all powerful. I mean, to be at his command. And he gives supernatural, not just average, not just a little, supernatural counsel and guidance to his children, if we choose to remain and abide in him, right? And then I like this word, he imparts great wisdom. Proverbs 1 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. He imparts. It has something to do with that is this word that imparts great wisdom. It means something remarkable, magnificent, something strong, great. The word's gadol. It's not just your average, you know, it's halfway decent. It's gadol wisdom. It is big, strong, mighty, remarkable, and he gives it to us. So this verse just, you know, if ever a verse come out and just get you. This is Net Bible. Some different words, but it hit me one day, and I passed that along to us. And one thing I know they mentioned, you know, we've come out of a crazy couple of years. And we sometimes wonder, God, we're looking for some guidance here. God, we're looking for some wisdom here. But you know what? Unless there is an issue, generally speaking, we don't get to see the hand of God guiding us when life is just easy floating through. We're okay, but it's when those times are tough. That's when we especially, Lord, I need some supernatural guidance, counsel. I need gadol wisdom and impart it to us. And so, you know, this last year and a half or two, it's God giving us opportunities to come to him and hear his willingness, our willingness to respond to him. And that all him trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust. So I'm going to send a home an assignment with you, and somehow maybe we'll collect it in the next week. Yeah, I'm coming to your house. Doug especially. So if I were to ask you, what did you learn in the last year and a half of pandemic? okay, good. What did you learn? And you know, I thought that to myself and go, man, I gotta write this down because I'm running out of fingers to remember all this stuff, you know. What did, and there's a lot that we've learned, probably, maybe even the good, the bad, the ugly, because we saw the best of humanity and the worst of humanity. We saw the best of the body of Christ and sometimes not so pretty parts of the body of Christ. So I'd like you, this is your assignment, to be thinking about what you personally have learned about God, about yourself, the wisdom and guidance he's provided, we've made it through, and yet what we still don't know what God holds in the future, but we trust him. But this verse, the Lord's still in control, and someday he's coming back, right? The trump of God shall sound, the dead in Christ arise, we which are alive and remain will be caught up together with them in the Lord, so shall we ever be with this Lord. And what are we to do? Encourage each other with this. So look back, and you know what? I bet you can find some supernatural guidance, personally and in the body of Christ, as well as this great wisdom that he has given and he continues to give to us. So that's your assignment. We'll ask some more this next week, but be thinking about that as this verse, and it's Isaiah, and you're welcome to look at it in different translations, 28, 29 of Isaiah, the God who commands 10 million angels. Lord of hosts means armies, and he gives supernatural guidance and imparts great wisdom. So Lord, we respond by faith and trust. When we've acknowledged this last year or two, we've all struggled in some way or another. We've had loss, personal loss, painful loss, maybe financially, maybe uncertainty, maybe our own inner struggles with the systems that have changed and we don't know from day to day, and the lack of community. Whatever it is, Lord, you're in control. And Lord, you, in your graciousness, give to us supernatural guidance. And you impart great wisdom. And we cling to that. And by faith, believe that you're working in and through us. And may we look back with the guidance of your Spirit to see what we have learned. And we are stronger and better in our faith as a result of it. We thank you. Lord, bless and guide. Thank you so much for Chosen, their ministry to us. May you provide for them. May you give them traveling mercies and rest for the days to come. Each one here, may you bless. Lord, we especially think of Mark Tweest, and that you guide him and the doctors and his health concerns. We trust you in all things. In the name of Jesus and all God's people said, amen, amen and amen.
All right, we'll do just one or two more if that's all right. You guys want to sing another one with us?
Sure.
Have you enjoyed yourself this morning? Will you give Pastor Kurt a hand for having us? Thank you so much. All right, you should know a lot of these. Like I said, we grew up singing Southern gospel music, so this is our rendition of doing them all at the same time. Be all right? I'm So we had to put a little bit of a bluesy groove on it. Sounds kind of cool, we think. We'll see what you guys think. Thanks again so much for having us. Come say hi at the table if you can. Like I said, we just came out with the God is Good CD. We actually just got this week in the mail God is Good hats, God is Good t-shirts. It's a great message to simply say God is good in my life. At the same time, we have, so on that new CD, God is Good, Not the Only One, Ain't No Grave is on there that we played today. We have a praise and worship CD that has Your Grace is Enough and a lot of other songs on there. We have a Back to Our Roots CD that has the hymn medley in the right key. It also has Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone on there. Now, there will be one song on there that you will be very confused on. How does this make Back to Our Roots? Like I said, we all come from different backgrounds. So while we were raised on a bus singing Southern gospel music, this man right here was not. He was rocking and rolling. So we put a rendition. Again, we play a lot of biker shows. We took Sweet Home Alabama, and we sang Amazing Grace during the verses, and then the chorus says, Sweet Home Up in Heaven, where this guy is so blue, Sweet Home Up in Heaven, Lord, I'm coming home for you. And yesterday at the biker rally, there was two songs that got, it was a space about like this, right, but it was outside, your whole parking lot, and they were everywhere, like 60, 80 people everywhere. When we hit Ain't No Grave, all 80 people were right here, rocking and rolling, and then they came back when we hit Sweet Home. So it's just a cool way to connect. So when you go, man, this doesn't fit, oh, how I love Jesus, the hymn medley, how great the R is on there, doesn't fit any of that, that's why. It's his fault. If you don't like it, it's his fault. If you do like it, it's his fault. Either way, it's on him. You guys ready to see if we can learn this? We've only done this like once, so it should be fun. This is like a cardinal sin to leave with a song you really don't know, but it's all right. We get it from our dad, right? There's a light in the window, a table spread in splendor. Oh, 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 a second. And the soul's heart's crying, think I'll spread my wings for flight. Lord, I've been dreaming this haunted before.
Next week as well. So thank you, blessings, and make sure you say appreciation.